We try to find the best appraisers in the area. Every AMC is going to tell you that. We're looking for the appraisers that, if let's just say out of 100 appraisers in the area, 70 of them say, here's what we think is customary and reasonable fee. Mm-hmm. That's what we're going to be due.
Originating from deep inside the Rocky Mountains, transported through the power of the internet, and arriving inside your tiny earbuds. It's the Appraiser Coach Podcast, helping appraisers increase their efficiency, quality, and make more money. Here's the guy who makes it his life's mission to create value for real estate appraisers nationwide. Your host and the Appraiser Coach, Dustin Harris.
And welcome, folks. This is the Appraiser Coach Podcast. My name is Dustin Harris. You do hear a little noise in the background as people are walking up and down the venue here at the Valuation Expo 2016. We are sponsored today by OREP Insurance. OREP is your next E&O insurance. If it's not already, folks, check them out at OREP.org. We're also sponsored by A La Mode. A La Mode is my software that I've been using for over 2 decades, and it should be yours as well. Check them out right now at alamode.com. That's alamode.com/free trial, or you can go to 800-ALAMODE. And finally, we are sponsored by Data Master. Data Master is here at the venue and super excited to rub shoulders with these guys. Check out Data Master, folks. You can check them out at datamasterfreetrial.com/coach. That's datamasterfreetrial.com/coach. And we're back. Dustin Harris with you at the Valuation Expo 2016 in Las Vegas, Nevada. We're talking with some of the vendors here at the expo this year. And I have in front of me Mr. Tim Huffman of NVS. Welcome, Tim.
Thanks, Dustin, for having us.
Really appreciate you being here, and I appreciate you being on mic with us for a few minutes.
Absolutely.
So somebody walks past your booth. Tell us about yourself. Who do you represent? What is NVS?
NVS stands for Nationwide Valuation Solutions.
Well, that sounds like an AMC to me.
Yeah, that is an AMC, but maybe one of the better ones.
All right.
Hopefully, right?
All right, sell me.
We're based out of Phoenix. I'm a certified appraiser. I started with my partner, who's also a certified appraiser, and we felt there's a better way to do it.
Okay.
To where we could be an advocate for the appraisers and try to take care of the appraisers, unlike some other larger AMCs,
I like that.
Right?
Yeah.
So the appraisers like to work for us for that reason. Because we're there, we're trying to help them and protect them and look out for them. The lenders that our clients love to use us for several reasons. One is 100% of the appraisals that come through us is reviewed by a certified appraiser.
Okay.
Most AMCs.
Not some schmuck behind a desk.
That's right. Right. I think most AMCs have a automated review
sure.
system. We have that as well. But certified appraiser looks at everyone 100%.
Nice. Nice.
Front to back. Another thing that our clients like is our communication. If they have a question, they can call us and a certified appraiser will talk to them about their appraisal issues. That's just not every AMC has that. So we're
no, most
proud
of them
that.
Have $10 an hour
right.
people sitting behind a phone.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
I hear you. Okay.
Not that they can't do a great job, but we feel like, you know, we can step that up a notch.
Most appraisers are now going to be asking, okay, what about fees, Tim?
Right.
I mean, what can I expect from NVS?
Well, I think what we try to do is we try to find the best appraisers in the area. Every AMC is going to tell you that. We're looking for the appraisers that, if let's just say out of 100 appraisers in the area, 70 of them say, here's what we think is customary and reasonable fee.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're going to be due.
Okay.
Yeah. There's going to be some appraisers say, look, I'm going to charge $100 more than everyone.
Mm-hmm.
That's hard for us to sell to our clients
sure.
when we have qualified appraisers that will do it for something else. But we are not looking for sure not looking for the most affordable.
Right.
We're
right,
looking
the
for
the barrel.
Best quality appraiser for that job.
Okay. Talk to us about the appraisal industry. From your eyes, you see a very unique perspective. You are an appraiser, as you
yes.
mentioned. Your partner's an appraiser as well, but now you're on the AMC side.
Right.
What are the biggest challenges that you currently see to the appraisal industry, the appraisal profession going forward?
Well, I think all appraisers know that their job is getting tougher, seems like day by day. New lender requirements, regulations. The appraisers are the ones that are putting together a legal document. And I believe that most of what they're looking for, or what they fear, I should say, is someone coming back to them after the fact because of something that they missed.
Right.
I think that's a huge fear.
Liability's big.
Liability. There's a discussion about a great reduction in the number of appraisers. A lot of them are retiring, not new ones coming in. That can be a good thing, can be a bad thing. Good thing is the less appraisers there are, you know, maybe those fees can go up like all appraisers would like.
Supply and demand.
Supply and demand. We've all been at that same fee or close to it for 20 years. Mm-hmm. So we know what the appraisers are feeling there. So that's a tough thing. I think one of the great things is the appraisers that have kind of stuck it out through these years, they're seeing the benefit. Mm-hmm. They're maybe more so than they want to. They're so busy. They're
right, right.
Working 7 days a week. So I think there's good and bad right now.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So last question. Let's say I live in Anchorage, Alaska, and I want to be a part of the NVS team. Can I be?
Sure. You can be. We don't have any work in Anchorage, Alaska right now.
All right. Let's say that I belong or that I live in Phoenix, Arizona.
Yes.
What would I do to sign up?
You go to our website, which is 1NVS.com.
Okay. And there's the number one?
The number one.
Okay.
NVS, just like our initials.
Okay. So NVS, remember, folks, this is Nationwide Valuation Services.
Solutions.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Because we got to make that distinction.
I'm reading it right off your card and I can't even read today.
So yeah, go right to our website, 1NVS.com, and it'll lead you right to sign up with us.
Perfect.
And go from there.
Tim Huffman, thank you for joining us.
Dustin Harris, sure appreciate it. Thank you.
And we're talking with a few of the vendors here at the Valuation Expo 2016. I'm sitting down with Mandy Tashida. Mandy, welcome.
Hi, thank you.
Good to have you here. So you're here representing Treasure Valley Factors.
Yes.
Which is a name that I have known for years and years and years. The first summit that I ever went to, I think there was like three vendors, and you guys were one of them.
Well, that's awesome. So, that's before my time. Yeah. So
it's nice to have you sit down with us. Most appraisers, I doubt, will know what a factoring company is. So let's start there.
Okay, so a factoring company is purchasing receivables. We purchase appraisals once they've been completed and submitted to the debtor. Then we can go ahead and pay that appraisal up front. We wait the time to be paid. We do any collections on the back end. We can take care of any additional billing, any collection calls. We try to chase down that money for them.
Okay, so are you a collection company?
No, definitely not.
Okay. Tell us the difference.
Not a collection company. The difference is a factoring company purchases current receivables.
Okay.
Collection company goes after the money after it's aged
out. It's past due. Okay.
Past due, okay. Yep.
So what would cause an appraiser to come to a factoring company when, hey, I can just bill out the company myself?
A lot of that is getting paid up front. So they don't want to wait 30 days to be paid. That's a long time for somebody to wait. They can have the cash in hand. A lot of times the same day that they complete the appraisal, we can go ahead and pay it. Another reason is they don't have time to go after that money. They don't have time to take care of that, you know, back end part of it.
Right.
They have to complete their appraisals and go out there and do another one. So sometimes they have stuff sitting on their books that they don't even know about.
Okay, here's the scenario. So I do an appraisal today and I'm going to bill that company $400 for that appraisal. I don't want to wait 30 days, 45 days, sometimes 60 days to receive. I'm not worried about this company paying. They're good to pay, but they are kind of slow. I did the work now. They wanted that work done ASAP, right? I want to be paid ASAP. Mm-hmm. So I would come to a company like yours and what, give you the invoice?
It depends on the company. We don't require that you send in an invoice. A lot of companies don't require that. So we ask for the order sheet, the letter of engagement, whatever they have sent to you to provide the information that we need to put it into the system. And then also proof that it's been delivered. So if it's an AMC, they'll have, you know, an online platform where it says in review, it's been completed. we'll ask our customer to take a screenshot of that and send it in. That prevents us from having to call the AMC every single day.
Right.
Because they would get annoyed really quick if we did that.
Absolutely. Okay. So obviously there's something involved for you on this.
Yes.
What was the cost to an appraiser to do something like that? I can see the benefit in getting paid today. As you mentioned, number one, it's upfront cash. Number two, I don't have to worry about the follow-up. I don't have to worry about sending the invoice and, hey, we haven't been paid. It's been 30 days. We need to send out another invoice. It's now been 45 days. I've got to make a phone call. I want to avoid all that junk. Time is money for an appraiser.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously, there's a cost involved. What are we looking at?
We have a 5% flat fee. That comes off right on top of the invoice. When we pay it, we take it out, and we advance the full 95%.
Hmm.
It's a flat rate, so it doesn't matter how long the invoice goes out. We don't, you know, the fee does not fluctuate from there.
What if I wanted to send you all of my invoices? Is that possible, number one?
Yes.
Okay. What if it's a company I'm a little bit worried about? In fact, let me ask you this. Not just it's a company I'm a little bit worried about as far as whether they're actually going to pay at all. You say you're not a collection company, but let's say it's a brand new invoice that it hasn't been 30 days, hasn't been 60 days, hasn't been 90 days. It's only been one day, but I don't know about this company. Or the follow-up to that, second question, is what about non-lender stuff? So I do something for an attorney. I do something for a homeowner. Do you do any of that side?
To answer the first question, if you're a little bit worried about it, we do free credit checks. So to prevent that from happening, we ask that our clients call in before they accept the work.
Okay.
And they can ask if we'll factor it or not. That way they don't get into that bind.
Gotcha. So you know up front.
Yeah, we do. We like to.
Yeah.
If we don't and there's a company that they didn't call on, we can go ahead and try to factor it. It just depends on what we can find on that company. But we do try to keep an open mind on, you know, giving somebody a shot. To answer the second question, we don't typically work with the borrowers and individuals directly, but we have worked with attorneys in the past.
Okay, very good. Anything else that an appraiser should know if they were interested in Treasure Valley Factors? How can they get a hold of you?
They can call us at 888-777-9881. And a really big part of our program that has benefited a lot of our customers is that we're non-recourse. So if a company goes out of business after we've purchased the invoice, we don't go back to the appraiser for that for payment. We eat that debt and just keep moving on.
Nice to know.
Yep.
Mandy Tashida, thank you for joining us from Treasure Valley Factors.
Thank you.
And I think that would be a good place to stop here and just pause for a minute and talk a little bit about our sponsors. We're sponsored first by OREP Insurance. Folks, OREP is the company that you should be going to for your E&O. Why? They are not an insurance company. They are an insurance broker with benefits, and that is the key. You can probably get similar prices most everywhere else. Although, I will tell you, when I switched to OREP, I saved money the first year and the second year. I think you probably can too, but that's not the only reason you should switch. You need to check out their benefits page. Go to OREP.org and do the benefits drop down. I've got a couple of courses on there that I think that would be beneficial to you. They are connected with Working RE Magazine, and they are a great company if you want to have the best E&O coverage and the best benefits. It's OREP.org. We are also sponsored by Data Master. Data Master is here at the Valuation Expo 2016. They're at pretty much all of these conferences sharing what they do. Folks, if you've not checked out what they do, if you've not been to one of these conferences or not gone to their website, you need to check them out. It's datamasterfreetrial.com/coach. I'll give that to you one more time. datamasterfreetrial.com/coach, and you can learn more about how Data Master can save you 30 to 60 minutes per report. Folks, you need to check out Data Master, and you need to be using Data Master. Finally, we are sponsored here today by Ulamode Software. Ulamode is the software that I've been using for 2 decades. They've been around for over 3 decades, helping appraisers be more efficient, more effective. Everything we talk about here at the Appraiser Coach Podcast, that's what Ulamode does. They are the leader in the appraisal industry. They are the leader in software. Why? Well, folks, you can find out right now for 15 days free. You can get their total package, all the bells, all the whistles, all the tech support for free, 15 days. It's alamode.com/free trial. That's alamode.com/free trial. here at the Valuation Expo 2016, and we are talking with vendors. We're talking with the booths that people have put up here to get to know appraisers and appraisers get to know them. We're talking with different vendors that we did not talk to in Baltimore, and we're going to dive right back into that right now. And welcome back, folks. I am sitting down with Hemant Jindal from IE Impact. That is a name that appraisers, I think, know. Most appraisers know, but welcome. Appreciate you sitting down with me on the mic for just a few minutes.
Yeah, I think most people might not know me, but I think IE Impact, most appraisers should know because we are trying to reach almost everybody. So IE Impact Appraisal Data Entry Service.
I think it is a household name. Maybe not your name specifically, but I think appraisers know exactly what IE Impact is. But let's just pretend that appraisers have been living in a cave and they don't know what IE Impact does. Tell us briefly your elevator speech.
Okay. So basically what we do is just like what you are currently doing yourself. When you start a report, you type in the report, you do a lot of data entry. You know, sometimes you spend 40 minutes of data entry, sometimes you spend 2 hours of data entry. We do all that for you. We basically punch in all that numbers and letters using the keyboard. We are not like automated software or something.
Okay.
So we can do all
you got
that
human for beings
you.
Doing that.
We are
right?
Human beings, okay. Doing manually typing the report so that you cannot have any hand CPT kind of problems, basically.
Nice. So in other words, we here on the Appraiser Coach Podcast talk a lot about efficiencies. We talk about outsourcing. We talk about technology. You're talking about all of those things.
Yep. Yes.
So as an appraiser, I want to save time,
yeah,
but I don't want to cut quality,
yeah,
right? Why would I come to IE Impact?
So we have been in this business from almost 7 years.
Okay.
We know we do make mistakes. And when we make mistakes and we do get feedback, if we don't get feedback, we will not be improving. So when we get the feedback, all we need is your feedback, is your completed report.
Mm.
Then we just compare our report with your completed report. And then we learn from you this way. You know, we don't want you to spend a lot of time on correcting ourselves something.
Right.
So that way we can just mimic what you did, what you are doing.
Gotcha. So an appraiser, if they want to improve the service,
yeah,
simply sends you back the completed report. You can point by point find out what has been changed.
Yeah, we have the technology. We have the PDF div program.
Mm.
You know, where we can even see you put a comma, you put a dot, you know, you made caps, all that. We can see every single dot change you made. You know, and then all we tell our guys, you know, if appraiser is doing that, it means that's his need. No, so make sure you do that. Don't
right.
let him waste time correcting your stuff.
Correcting your stuff. Okay,
yeah.
Good. That's good to know. How long does it take a new customer to feel like, okay, these guys are trained in now, they get how I want things, I'm feeling like this is worth it?
So normally we have seen like first 3 reports, if they, you know, they use like 1 report at a time,
mm,
the first 3 reports, even some appraisers are just starting from first report, they send, I just want this report getting within 6 hours, you know, just do it enough as quickly as possible. So that are the worst people, I would say, for us, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Don't use our service if you are in rush or something. Don't start our service during that time when you are so much in a rush to get 5 reports done fast.
Which is probably the time that they need you most, right?
Yeah. So if that's a thing, you know, then at least send us 1 report.
Mm.
Don't send us all 5 reports.
Gotcha.
Time, you know?
Okay.
Then we can fine tune your service, you know, and ask you questions, what
good
do you want.
Okay. So I'm going to put you on the spot a little bit.
Sure.
As I reach out to appraisers and talk about data entry services,
yep,
the 2 questions that always come up are, number one, is this USPAP compliant?
Okay.
Now, I want to pause here for just a second and remind the listeners, as they already know,
yep,
reports are not USPAP compliant, appraisers are.
Yep.
That being said, I think appraisers still are concerned about the compliancy of outsourcing data entry.
Okay.
What is your answer to that question?
Okay, so I always tell, like, we always even, it's on our website also, are you USAP, USPAP compliant, you know? So we, like, how we are USPAP compliant, that's, we are basically following all of your instructions.
Right.
We are not really doing any judgment work. Whatever you are putting on paper, we are putting that same paper on your
software. Analysis, just data entry.
Adjustments we are doing. Okay. We are not replacing your job or anything like that. You know.
So anything you would have your data entry person in your office do, you're simply doing it to you. Okay, good. So the second question that comes up is people ask about security.
Yep.
They ask about privacy.
Yep.
I don't want to send my data to somebody who's going to mine that data and then resell it,
okay.
Right? So that's their concern. So, Hemant, how would you respond to that question?
So, first of all, like whatever the data we get, that stays in your account. When you start with us, you create your account. That account is only seen by you or our data entry people. We don't even share account, something like that. Like we don't pull one appraiser record into some other, because that's how we cannot manage, because we manage close to 5,000 appraisers. So if we start doing that, we cannot even manage our stuff, you know.
Mm.
So everything is individual based. Whatever your data, that's your data. Even we delete reports after, I think, 15 days. We don't even keep anything, you know. We can even build a database like for you if you want, but we are not in that business.
Right. You're not in the data sharing business.
We are not in data
sharing. Not in the data collection business.
Yes.
So confidential stays
even
confidential.
Like what we did last month, we had, I think, 1 terabyte of data. We couldn't even handle that. We had to just delete all the data, right?
Nice to know.
Yeah.
Nice to know. Okay. So I'm a new customer. I'm interested anyway, potential customer. I come to you and say, okay, this sounds expensive.
Okay. You should say it, okay. Let's say we save you 2 hours per report.
Okay.
Now you say 2 hours is like divided by 2 is 50 per report. If you think that's expensive, I will say then you are not really earning so much money or something that you think
right.
is expensive.
Right, you're working minimum wage.
You should be
easily
able to pay us at least $25 per report, but
yeah.
We don't want that because we are fine with $15 per report.
Nice.
You know?
Okay.
But if you're a volume customer, we will give you a discount as well, like
nice.
So that we can save you money as well.
Very good.
Yeah.
Hey, Mark Jindal from IE Impact, thank you for joining us.
Yeah,
this
thank
has
you.
Been very informative.
Thank you. Thank you, Dennis. Thank you so much.
Well, folks, that ought to wrap it up here. We've been talking with the vendors here at the Valuation Expo 2016, November 2016 here in Las Vegas, Nevada. It's been a lot of fun. Beautiful weather outside. Folks, if you missed it, which you obviously did if you're listening to this post-production, next year, folks, next year in Orlando in March, and I believe they said October in Las Vegas. So Orlando in March and October in Vegas. Join us next time. It will be worth whatever you need to put aside to be here. That's Valuation Expo 2017 next year. And we'll catch you next week here on the Appraiser Coach Podcast.
You've been listening to the Appraiser Coach Podcast with Dustin Harris. If you like what you hear, please give us a 5-star rating and post a short review on iTunes. For more in-depth insider information on how you can make more money as a real estate appraiser, visit theappraisercoach.com and sign up for the All-Star team today. Thanks for joining us. And now, get out there and create some value.